Hello everyone, this is Vipin Bhure from Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering, GH Raisoni Academy of Engineering and Technology, Nagpur. Today's our topic is Introduction to Digital Circuits and Introduction to Basic Logic Gates. Basically, circuits, electronic circuits are categorized into two categories. First is digital circuit and second is analog circuit. Basically, digital circuits work on digital signal. Digital signal such as digital signal having two values, two discrete values, 0 and 1. In TTL logic, 0 means, in TTL logic, 0 means 0 volt and 1 means 5 volt. Basically, maximum digital circuits which we are using for our practical applications are manufactured or designed through the TTL logic. In TTL logic, as I have already shown, 0 means 0 volt and 1 means 5 volt. In digital circuit, basic building block is the logic gates. We are having 7 logic gates, out of which 5 are the basic gates and 2 are the universal gate. Basic gates are AND gate, OR gate, NOT gate, AND gate. This is the symbol of basic AND gate. AND gate having 2 inputs. Let us consider A and B, and output is A dot B. AND gate, if we are designing the truth table for AND gate, for combination of input and output, A, let us consider A and B are the input and output is Y, then the combination of two inputs are 0 0 0 1 1 0 and 1 1. At the output of AND gate, we get for 0 0 we get 0, for 0 1 we get 0, for 1 0 we get 0, and for 1 1 we get 1. Inside this symbol, basically the transistorized circuit which operate on AND logic. Transistorized circuit which operate on AND logic consists of one transistor. Basically, it consists of semiconductor device transistor. Let us consider semiconductor device N. P. N. For example, here consider negative charge, here consider positive charge. Electrons from here trying to travel through this N, P and N region towards the positive charge. But due to the depletion layer, these electrons are not capable to travel from negative charge to the positive charge. For that, here additional terminal is added and small positive charge is applied here, so that now this depletion layer get thinner and electrons are capable to travel from this negative towards positive, and current flow from this in this direction. Let us consider the symbol of transistor. This is the basic symbol of transistor. This is ammeter, this is collector, and this is base. If we want to design transistorized AND gate, then the circuit is circuit consists of two transistors. Let us consider name of this transistor is T1, this transistor is T2, and we are considering our two inputs such as A and B. Here we are considering our two inputs here, A and input B. Input A is applied to the base of transistor T1, input B is applied to the base of transistor T2. Here at the collector of transistor T1 we are applying plus 5 volt, at the emitter of transistor T2 through this resistance we are applying ground. ground means we are considering it as no voltage or zero volt. From collector, from the emitter of transistor T2, from the emitter of transistor T2, we are taking the output. This is the transistorized diagram for the AND gate. In the AND gate, as we are considered from the truth table, A and B and output Y, here we are giving the name to the output is Y. Firstly, if transistor want to conduct at that time, we have to maintain some voltage at this base terminal, at this terminal some positive voltage at the base terminal, if we want to trigger the transistor. Here we are using the two transistor T1 and T2, inputs are applied at the base of transistor T1 is A and at the base of transistor T2 is B. For if we want to turn on this transistor or we have to make this transistor work in saturation region, we have to apply some positive voltage at this A input. If we want to turn on this transistor T2, we have to apply the some positive voltage at the B terminal, input terminal B. Okay, here firstly we consider A and B are 0, 0. Here 0 volt and at the B terminal 0 volt. In this case, 0 volt is not sufficient to make transistor T1 on. Here 0 applied at the B is not sufficient to make the transistor T2 on. So here transistor work as open switch, transistor T1 and T2 work as open switch. Whatever the voltage we have applied at the collector of transistor 5 volt, we are applying at the collector of transistor T1. Due to this voltage, current is trying to travel from the 5 volt towards the ground, but due to open circuit of created due to the off transistor T1 and T2, this current is not capable to travel through transistor T1 and T2 towards the output or towards the ground. So we are getting 0 output voltage. In the second case, let us consider at the A we are having applying 0 volt and at the B we are applying 1. 1 means as per TTL logic, 1 means 5 volt. Here we are applying at the A 0 volt and at the B 5 volt. Now in for this configuration, for this condition, transistor T1 is off because at the base we are having 0 volt, it is not capable to make transistor T1 on, and transistor T2 is on, it is work as a closed switch, and transistor T1 work as an open switch. So currents trying to travel through transistor T1 and transistor T2, but transistor T1 is off, transistor T1 is act as an open switch, it is not capable to travel from transistor T1. So we are getting output 0 volt. In second condition, we are getting output 0 volt. In the third configuration, we are having A is equal to 1. For TTL logic, A is equal to 1 means 5 volt, B is equal to 0. For the TTL logic, B is equal to 0 means 0 volt. Now transistor T1 is on, transistor T1 is on, so this switch is closed. Transistor T2 is off, this switch is open. Current through this voltage supply trying to travel from the collector to the emitter of transistor T1 and from the collector of transistor T2 to the emitter of transistor T2, but this current is not capable to travel through the transistor T2 because it is off. So we are getting output same as that of the previous state, 0 volt. In the last configuration, let us consider A is equal to 1 and B is equal to 1. A is equal to 1. Again, for the TTL logic, we are considering 1 means 5 volt and 0 means 0 volt. So we are having the two inputs, at the two inputs, the voltage level is 5 volt and 5 volt. Now this is the configuration where transistor T1 is also on. So it transistor T1 is also transistor T1 is on and transistor T2 is also on. So both are the closed switch. Now current travel from collector of transistor T1 to the emitter of transistor T2, and we are getting the output here 1. So through the truth table we found that this circuit satisfy this truth table. Let us consider our second gate is OR gate. This is the basic symbol of OR gate. OR gate having two inputs A and B. This is basically two input OR gate. A and B are the inputs and Y is the output. For truth table we are having, as we are having two inputs A, B, and output is our Y. These are the two inputs and this is output Y. If we are having two input, that is why we are having four configurations 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0 and 1, 1. In OR gate, whenever we are applying A is equal to 0 and B is equal to 0, we are getting output 0. Whenever we are applying A is equal to 0 and B is equal to 1, we are getting 1. Whenever we are applied A is equal to 1 and B is equal to 0, we are getting 1, and 1 is equal to A is equal to 1 and B is equal to 1, we are getting 1. For only configuration A is equal to 0 and B is equal to 0, we are getting output 0, and for other three configurations we are getting 1. Let us consider the transistorized OR gate. In transistorized OR gate we are having two transistors. T1 and T2. At the collector of both the transistors we are applying plus 5 volt. At the emitter of both the transistors through the resistor we are giving ground. These are our inputs A and input B. At the emitter of both the transistors we are taking output as a Y. As per the truth table, as these are the transistors T1 and T2, these are the transistors. These transistors turn on when and only when we are applying some positive voltage at the base of transistor T1 and T2, and at the base of transistor means at the input A and at the input B. As per our truth table, firstly consider the condition A is equal to 0 and B is equal to 0. We are applying at the A, that is at the base of transistor T1, A 0, and base of transistor T2 0. So that both these transistors are off, act as open switch. Whenever we are applying 5 volt at the collector of both the transistors, current is traveling from 5 volt through to travel from 5 volt towards the ground. But as both the transistors T1 and T2 are off for our condition A is equal to 0 and B is equal to 0, so current is not capable to reach at the output. So we are getting the output 0. For second condition, let us consider A is equal to 0 and B is equal to 1. For A is equal to 0 means at the base of transistor T1 we are applying 0, at the base of transistor T2 we are applying 1, at the base of transistor T2 we are applying 1. Whenever we are applying 0 at the base of transistor T1, so it is off, and 1 means 5 volt according to the TTL logic, transistor T2 is on. Current start travel through this supply through transistor T1 towards this resistor. Now whatever the potential available across this resistance, we are getting it at the output terminal. So we are getting output is equal to 1, Y is equal to 1 for the second configuration. In third configuration, let us consider A is equal to 1 and B is equal to 0. as per our consideration, here A is equal to 1 means it is 5 volt as per TTL logic, and T2 is equal to 0 means here we are applying 0 volt. As we are applying 0 volt at the base of transistor T2, so it is off, and we are applying 5 volt at the base of transistor T1, so it is on. Now current is traveling through this supply voltage to transistor T1 towards this resistance, towards the ammeter. Now we are getting the output is equal to 1. In fourth configuration, we are having A is equal to 1 and B is equal to 1, means we are applying high voltage at the base of transistor T1 and the base of transistor T2. So both the transistors T1 and T2 are on, and we are getting the output is equal to 1. This is the basic concept of, this is the basic transistorized diagram of OR gate, and its working is explained through this truth table. Now let us consider our next gate, that is NOT gate. This is the basic symbol of NOT gate. NOT gate having one input, and at the output of NOT gate we are getting the inverted input. Whatever the input we are applying at the we are getting at the output, it is in inverted form. So basic truth table of NOT gate, in NOT gate as we are having only one input, so we are considering input and output. If we are applying input is equal to 0 at the output, the inversion of 0 is 1, and if we are applying at the input 1, then we are getting at the output 0. As per the transistorized diagram concept, let us design transistorized diagram. We are having only one transistor. We required only one transistor to design inverter circuit. Let us consider this transistor T. We are applying 5 volt at the collector of the transistor, and ammeter is grounded. Whenever A at the input A, let us consider this is the input and it is A. Whenever we are applying 0, 0 means as per the TTL logic, we are applying 0 volt at this gate terminal, at the base terminal of transistor. So transistor T is off, it acts as a open switch, and current is not capable to travel through this transistor T towards the ground. Whatever the we are applying at the input, we are getting it at the this output terminal. This is our output terminal. In the next configuration, let us consider we are applying the input as a 1. Input as a 1 means 5 volt. So now this voltage is capable to make the transistor T on. So transistor T on, as the transistor T on, it acts as a closed switch. Whatever the current trying to flow through this transistor T is grounded through this transistor, as it acts as a closed switch, and we are getting output as a 0 as shown in truth table. These three are our basic logic gates. After this, we are having NAND gate and NOR gate as a logic gate. Firstly, let us consider NAND gate. NAND gate NAND gate. NAND gate is, if I expand this name NAND, NAND means NOT plus AND, means NOT plus AND. NOT plus AND means NAND. Firstly, AND gate, as we already know, AND gate having two inputs A and B, and at the output of AND gate we are getting A dot B. And NOT means simple single input gate. This is the symbol of NOT gate. So at the output of NOT gate here, we are getting A dot B bar. Bar is nothing but the inversion of whatever the input we are applying at the input terminal of NOT gate. It get inverted and we are getting at the output A dot B bar. This is the output equation of our NAND gate. Let us go through the symbol. Here NOT gate is replaced by small bubble which we are including it at the output side of our AND gate. This is the basic symbol of NAND gate, and at the output of NAND gate we are getting A dot B bar. Let us go through the truth table. As per our input consider, as we are considering the two inputs A and input B, as we are considering the two input, input A and B, we are getting the output Y. Y means A dot B bar. Firstly, consider input configuration 0, 0. As we are applying 0, 0 here, at the output of AND gate, we are getting 0, and 0 get inverted through this NOT gate. So, we are getting A dot B bar is equal to 1. Next configuration 0, 1. Whenever we are applying A is equal to 0 and B is equal to 1, as the output of AND gate, we are getting here again 0. 0 is again inverted at the output of NOT gate. So, we are getting A dot B bar means 0 is inverted, so that we are getting 1. Next, we are considering 1, 0. 1, 0 means A is equal to 1 and B is equal to 0. So, at the output, as we already know that at the output of AND gate, we are getting 1 when and only whenever the both the inputs or whatever the inputs we are applying all are 1. At that time only when at that time we are getting the output of AND gate 1. In this case we are considering 1, 0. 1 at the A we are considering 1, at the B we are considering 0. So, at the output of AND gate we are getting 0, and 0 is applied to the input of inverter that is NOT gate, and we are getting final output is as 1. As per consider the last configuration, that is A is equal to 1 and B is equal to 1. A is equal to 1 and B is equal to 1, we are getting at the output of AND gate, at the output of AND gate we are getting 1, and 1 is applied as an input to the inverter, and at the output of inverter, that is our NOT gate, at the output of NOT gate we are getting 0. This is complete truth table for NAND gate. As we know that NAND gate is derived from AND gate. If let us go to our next gate, that is our NAND NOR gate. NOR gate is also one of the universal gates. NOR gate. NOR, if we expand this NOR, it is NOT plus OR, our NOT gate, and if we consider we are connecting, if we connect A, B, this is our OR gate, and at the output of OR gate, if we connect NOT gate, by the combination of OR and NOT, we are getting NOR gate. This is, let us go through the truth table for NOT gate, for the NOR gate. As shown in this symbol, in this diagram, we are having two inputs A, B, and at the output we are, let us consider Y, output is Y, our output is Y. As the combination A, B is 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. whenever we are applying our first configuration, that is 0 0, at the input of this first our OR gate 0 0, at the output of OR gate we are getting, whenever we are applying 0 0, at the output of OR gate we are getting 0, and this 0 is applied as an input to the inverter. Inverter means at the output of inverter we are getting 1. So at the final output of inverter, final output of NOR gate is 1 for our configuration 0 0. Let us consider our second configuration, that is 0 and 1. Whenever we are applying at the A 0 and at the B 1, at the output of OR gate we are getting 1, and we are applying this 1 to the input of the inverter, and to the input of inverter we are applying 1, then at the output of inverter we are getting 0. So the final output of this configuration is 0. Whenever we are applying our third configuration, that is A is equal to 1 and B is equal to 0, let us consider here A is equal to 1 and B is equal to 0. At the output of OR gate again we are getting 1, and this 1 is again applied to the as an input to the inverter. So we are getting inversion of 1, that is 0. So final output of our NOR gate for configuration 1 and 0 is 0. Last configuration, here we are having two inputs A and B. A is our 1 and B is our 1. So consider here A is equal to 1 and B is equal to 1. At the output of inverter we are getting, at the output of OR gate we are getting 1. This 1 is we are applying to the as an input to the inverter. So at the output of inverter we are getting 0. So final output of our NOR gate is 0. Whenever we are considering NAND as a, we are considering NAND as a NOT plus AND and NOR as a NOT plus OR. So let us consider the truth table of both NAND, both NAND and AND gate. So firstly, again consider input here A and B, and output of AND, output of NAND. Firstly, we are having input 0 0. At the output of AND gate we are getting 0. For 0 1, at the output of AND gate we are getting 0. At the for 1 0 we are getting 0. For 1 1 we are getting 1. But when we are considering the truth table of NAND gate, for the these previous three configuration we are getting continuous 1, and at the last configuration we are getting 1 for AND gate and 0 for NAND gate. It proves that the NAND is configuration of AND and NOT. If we are inverting the inputs of AND gate, all the inputs of AND gate, we are getting the output of NAND gate. Same in case of NOR gate. Let us draw the truth table. In the truth table we are having, two inputs A, B, and output of OR and output of NOR. As the configuration, we are considering here, we are having two inputs 0 configuration, as we are having two inputs 0 0 1 0 0 1 1 1. As the, from the truth table of OR gate we are getting, for 0 0 we are getting 0, for the 1 0 we are getting 1, for 0 1 we are getting 1, and for 1 1 we are getting 1. But as we know that, as we, for the NOR gate we are connecting the NOT gate at the output of OR gate. So we are getting the output for NOR gate
as an inversion of the output of OR gate. Here we are getting 0 for the 0 0, but for NOR this 0 get inverted. We are getting 1 0, we are getting 1 for 1 0, so at the for the NOR we are getting 0, and so on. Here these are our basic gates. Here we are taking we are going through AND gate, OR gate, NOT gate, and two universal gate, NAND gate and NOR gate. Basically universal gates are the gates through which we can configure any Boolean expression or we can design any gate. After this, in next lecture we are going through two more gates, that are the XOR and XNOR gate. Thank you.